What's up, everybody? Just restarting the stream here because I think the sound wasn't working. Just make sure it is. So this is the beginning of the YouTube video again. I'm working on a ton of bug fixes this week. Yeah, cool. We got sound now. All right. And so I got to go do a God Mode play test and make sure all of the little bug fixes this week are all fixed. That's it. Rocket Bunny's doing Ludum Dare. Audio's good now. Nice. Sal's working on his research paper. And we're gonna start a new game. I got these controls, but I wanna add some. Keyboard controls. So what world seed are we gonna do today? I wanna check player controls. If I go and rebind, and then I try and mess with these. Yeah, cool. These one buttons work now. This is really great. Cheese! Cheese it is! We're gonna do cheese today! Pepperoni and cheese! I like how you spell cheese. Let's make sure this is all looking good here. No possible hidden positions! So I just crashed because of this one little assertion failure. It's cool. Let's comment this out. What's up, Kovarni? Nice. The Oregon Trail, huh? The one room? The one room is Oregon Trail-y? Saving bindings, refreshing bindings. Let's make sure these bindings bound correctly. Oh, what? The POVY does work? Oh, wait, no, that's just because it's on Windows it would work. Okay, cool, we're ready to go. I just gotta make it so when we assert fail, it doesn't actually quit the game. It just prints out an assert, but no need to exit. Not while we're doing this quasi-release mode thing. In fact, wait, you know what? I'm just gonna play in release mode. Might as well. Oh, you played Seed Cheese already? Cool. Oh, here lies pepperoni and cheese. Oh, Kovarni, you can't sleep. Oh man, I feel for you. I have the opposite problem. When I go to sleep, I can't stay asleep sometimes. The game already crashed. At least it wasn't World Seed Potato, but cheese killed it. But it's cool. It was just one of these little assertions from a one thing that doesn't really affect the whole game. It just causes it to generate a new world seed. Bandages and blood. You dream about jumping from the cliff in an ocean? What? And you had bloody elbows? Dang, man. But it was fun. All right. Well, I got a lot of ground to cover here, because I got to get all the way to that last dungeon at least. So I'm gonna go ahead and skip this. And I'm gonna start using my, instead of using the controller, I'm gonna use the keyboard. World Sea cheese. Cheese, please. No potato. I like it. There's lots of trees in this one. Oh, you wouldn't want to dive on from the floor? The smell of ozone. Yeah, you're probably right, huh? But, he's not an accurate person. This character. In his mind, it is plasma. What's up, HD? Welcome, man. Barfing, huh? Man, I'm like one of those people that can't barf. Like, I cannot make myself barf. I just hit Jib, but I don't think I did. Oh yeah, not just one lightning bolt. Ah, interesting. So maybe he is right, kinda. Alright, well, okay, so I'll do the first part not in God mode. Got the sword now. I do need to make sure that the mini boss still appears. Nothing. So this is good that this guy is appearing on this screen. He's not supposed to appear along gates anymore, or inside gates or whatever. Any kind of screen that has a gate, because you could potentially be locked behind a gate. Oh, whoops. Like, for example, if you walked onto a screen and it had a bunch of bombable pillars, and you didn't have bombs yet, and then this guy appeared on that screen too, he could lock you behind the bombable pillars, and you'd be like, shit, I'm stuck. The only way to get out of that would be to save and quit. So that's the bug I fixed there. I just wanted to make sure that that guy does appear into this whole little questy thing that happened with him. Can still happen. So it does. That's good. All right. So we can God mode away. God mode, proceed. Exit 25. Collision doesn't realize that? Stupid collision. Collision library. Love 2D. Love 2D's not giving you any love right now, man. Friggin' love 2D. Ooh, I just got a feeling this could be a secret right here. Yo, it is! Man, my programmer instincts are really good today. Okay, but seriously, I don't really need to be doing this in normal speed. I gotta go in like Godspeed. Godspeed! Godspeed to you, man. I'm doing a God mode playtest. There will be spoilers today. I gotta cover as much ground as I can and see all the stuff I changed this week and make sure I didn't break anything. Yeah, FS, all these keys are Vim keys. Basically, I'm keeping all my fingers on the home row. So I skipped around. I have an extra key now. Because I went through the... Well... So we're down at the end of a little hallway here. Okay, I guess I'll go back through this little secret wall. Lurk initiated. Entire game is crashing because of that. Lurk. Initiate lurk. Here he is. Method is being used. Is that the error you're getting? Method is being used? It's a weird one. This is probably the boss color. Yeah. There's the boss. Oh, that one? You're calling it the rubber ducky method? Oh, because the WTF method is being used right now. Oh. Lurk mode's failing. You can do it, man. Whoops. Oh, I just totally missed. cheated right there. Zero, where you at, man? Did I run out of bombs? Oh, I got bombs. Doop-a-doop-a-doo, testing out the game, testing out the game, testing out the game. Biodetector is very helpful for testing the game. What I need, though, is for Zero to start appearing. I don't think Zero's gonna appear, so that must mean that this dungeon 3 or whatever is... Swordless Dungeon is actually dungeon... in this world. But it's over here. Way. Dead end. Womp womp womp. What's up? Hey, what's up, dead guy? There it is. Nice. I like you how you prefaced that with lurk mode. Thank you. What's up with this? Sometimes these chests take forever to... I'm gonna note this. What screen is this? 362. Sometimes item chests can take forever to open after killing all enemies. As in, cheese 462. Is that right? 362. Bombs. Killed all these little spider guys, and there were no bombs. Well, totally gypped on the bombs here. Well, cheat? Yeah, I'm gonna cheat. Cheating! Container! My favorite home chazzle! Be a pretty hard room, especially dungeon 2. I think I already noted that last playthrough. I forget. Let me look that up. Bomberman. The Bomberman? No. You can't use a sword. Yeah, the Bomberman is just getting the bombs. Only the bombs. And same thing with the Blinken and the Odd Job. The Odd Job is only the top hat. And Abe Blinken is only the blink. You can't get the sword. Crazy, right? I know. Yeah. It's a difficult challenge. You like that? Thank you. roll 999 times a world to get a special setup for it? No, no, Kovarni, you can, no matter what, you have to play, to play in permadeath mode to get those, because the only way to not get the sword is to play in permadeath mode. But basically, in permadeath mode, there's none of these little brambly things surrounding the first few screens. So you don't have to go inside the cave, you don't have to get the sword, you just go throughout the world, and you can get weapons because you can go find enough diamonds to get some bombs, or you can go sneak into a dungeon and find bombs. If it's just the top hat, you can also get the top hat inside Vel's cave if you don't get the encounter with the mini boss. So yeah, you don't have to get the sword. What key combo should debug mode be? Whatever sounds good to you, man. What would be totally natural for you? We got the teleport cube! Does, but indirectly. So if you translate it there, I'll go and update them manually on stream, or I mean on Steam. So yeah, basically yes. Nice, Rocket Buddy, that looks cool. Spend so much time. Nice, man. It looks really good. Kovarni, it might work. Thank you. it's not as fun playing the game in God mode. But it must be done. I must make a lot of progress and make sure that things all work for the sake of the players. Oh, I can't get through there right now because I haven't got that. I haven't got any fiery items. Which means I would be stuck inside this dungeon without completing it. Unless I cheat. And I'm totally going to. Man, this is a crazy random room. It's great how the algorithms for all the rooms, they can like layer over each other and create things that you never would have expected. Love it. Timing right there. Can you post some progress screenshots? Of course, man. Always. Yeah, you never have to ask that. Please go right ahead. Nice, man. Yeah, I'm interested in seeing how it's going. Sweet, man. Are those rats? Is that a rat? Or what is that enemy guy? God, I love how he's got a book in his hand. Oh, sweet, dude. Is this part of a cutscene? This looks awesome. Cool, dude. She's sexy. Cheating initiated. Oh, it's an imp and a cat. Oh, I thought that other one was a big rat. But it does make a sense that it's an imp. Sweet man, cutscenes. Oh yeah, like Splinter? Yeah, it kinda looked like Splinter. Splinter is cool. There he is. Sub-Zero. Nice. nice, man. I like it. I love 8-bit. It's my favorite art style. What's up, Zero? Hey, man, are you going in here? Okay, I'll go in here too. Oh, I should have spent some money before this. That's right, that is. It's kind of like trying to find something, right? Except kept saying querying all day. Wait a minute, this one? Oh yeah. Cactus pouch, woo! Oh, not the secret, yeah, yeah. Yeah. That's right, I got the sack. I can carry more than 255 diamonds. I don't even need to spend diamonds. I can hoard diamonds. It's like the first time I've ever been able to hoard diamonds on one of these little god mode runs. So yeah, one of the bugs fixed this week was opening this door. Never happened on Mac. Happened on Windows only. Because of a signed integer overflow. Freaking believe that. Sometimes a time value can be negative. But I fixed the way doors work now, so they don't rely on time anyways. They just rely on elapsed time. Which is a lot smarter way to do it. I get a whole row of life now. That good timing. But heck yeah. It did, right? It's good to fix bugs when people have them. Fix them really fast. Because then they're like, whoa, man. You're a developer that cares. You actually care about the quality of your product? What? It's over here. Why am I compelled to explore this way? Oh, check it. Just so happen to have a lighter that I can use to light these things. Kill all these enemies. Cheating. And you're the little indie that could. Chugga, 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 chugga. Cheat to get here? No, I didn't even cheat. Did not cheat to get here. Oh, Oh, I'm stuck. What am I doing? Where am I going? I'm trying to go this way. Can't craft it. Whoa, I should craft something, huh? There's fear back here. What's up, Smalls? Salad. I know, right? It's a good point. Shit, now I have to make a good game. We'll buy this. Thank you very much, store. Ghost Sword Fear? This might be kind of cool. Oh wait, this isn't the Ghost Sword, but anyways. Hey, whoa! So let's test this out. Cool, so that was one of the bugs where if you crafted a failed combo and then immediately picked it back up, you could cause it to actually... You could lose an item that way. It was crazy. Because you would accidentally be picking the item up twice. It was weird as hell. Fear sword, man. I don't normally craft this. I'm gonna try it. Hopefully it is. Oh no, yeah, Kovarni, you don't have to finish the whole game for that one. You just have to start the game. Yeah, you don't have to finish it. Right? Yeah, it's true, right? And that's something I kind of had to like deal with mentally when I first started. Because when you first start a game, you don't know if any... Especially when you're first starting out, you have no following. You have nobody you know that... I didn't know whether this game would be something people were interested in, you know? So I had to come to terms with the fact that people might not like this game. I might not ever get a following. And so I was like, well, if I was the only one that ever played this video game, I guess I would still make it. Because it sounds like a really fun game for me to play. So, and I always wanted to play a Zelda-like game kind of like this. So, that's why I made it. And it's just kind of a nice bonus that people do like it. It's a really nice bonus that the Kickstarter did succeed. Thanks to all these amazing backers. Thanks to all you viewers of the stream for making that freaking Kickstarter happen, seriously. If it wasn't for the stream, I'm not sure if the Kickstarter would have succeeded. Thanks, EG. So if I hang out here, are they gonna do some more dialogue? Oh yeah, they're like, here. Oh shit, that means I can't craft anything anymore. I can hack my save file. I'm gonna hack my save file. Cause I wanna be able to do stuff. That's okay. Man. I'm gonna note this. This is kind of a thing. It's kind of a bug, sort of. Smith quest can happen unintentionally, which is not good for players. Gotta make this is a high priority bug, kind of. Gotta think of a better way to initiate this whole quest. Like, I want players to purposefully initiate this. Yeah, stream, for sure. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, promotion, marketing. So, World Seed Cheese, I want to undo this whole initiating the Droid Smith quest. And the Ship Bridge Dialogue 2. Okay, so let's play again. Again! Like, if I go over here. Cool. What do you need to do? Maybe one more dungeon and then we'll do the rest. You have a tendency to forget. I do too. There's a bunch I've forgotten whether I backed them or not. Or I especially forget what level I backed them at. I'm like, did I back this at the game level or did I just like throw $10 at them without the game? I always forget. Speak friend and enter. What friend? Enter where? That's it's like, That's a riff off of Lord of the Rings. Do you know that quote from Lord of the Rings? When they're standing outside of that door and speak friend and enter. It's a scene from Lord of the Rings. So it's a joke and it's about like wait, let's look this one up. It's Friend of Durin, right? Yeah, it just means how do you say this? Oh, what's that? It's at any point of the game. No, it's when you walk through a wall. No, it's when you let me look this up. I forgot where this one actually initiates. Oh, okay, yeah. This is when it's at nighttime. So yeah, the Friend of Durin is when you walk a secret path at nighttime. Right, the years? Yeah. So does that make sense, Kavarni? Secret path at nighttime. Yeah, it was like if there was a secret path right here, I could walk along it, and if it was nighttime, it would open. But at daytime, it wouldn't open. Okay, there's an opening up there. Fear Sword is crazy because it works better when you're at low health. It's a risky item to have. Makes you want to stay at low health all the time. Now I'm going around the wrong way. Oh hey, there's this. Shit, we'll play this one. What's this one? You got it now? Oh, yeah? Yeah, yeah. Ice top hat, one of the best ices thingies. That was level 7. Playing the game in debug mode, running around, debugging the game. That's what I'm doing. Zelda, what's up, man? What are you stuck on? What kind of ideas? You doing Ludum Dare? What you doing, man? What you doing? Yeah, it's this weekend. So you want to work on something, but you don't know what. Do you have a genre in mind? Nothing in mind? No genre? Okay, let's think of some themes, eh? How about, superheroes. about fruits and vegetables. Oh, Shazzle! Killed myself! I died! Why did it start here? I guess because I teleported. Okay, screw this dungeon. We don't need this dungeon. We already got ice. One man army, that's a cool idea. Potatoes and cars? That's a cool one. Blueberries have feelings. Blueberries have feelings too. Make sure this still works. Ooh, shrunk to the size of a cell? That's cool. How about a game where you count pebbles of sand? Sounds pretty interesting, right? I'd play it. Sand bucket. You like that? Oh, I'm invincible. Turn off invincibility so we can do this. Into the unknown. Imagine they say syrup. Syrup. Oh, that was close though. I think that's purposeful. It adds that. It adds that little buffer of walking area. Abandoned! Abandoned with only a spoon! Abandoned on a lonely planet! No, Abe's not an erection. It's a joke off of the name, Abe Lincoln. Huh? You know what I mean? Which is Abraham Lincoln. Just a joke. Probably doesn't make much sense in... But yeah, that's the one where you have to use only the blink. died there, had to cheat. Okay, we're ready to do the Songbringer dungeon and finish this. Oh, because in God mode, it started me on top of this. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Untranslatable puns. Did I get poison? No, I don't need more. I don't need a crafting thing more. I'm ready to do this. Ready to make it happen. Finish the game. Twist. Never left Earth? You're a forgotten potato? Oh, crazy. This one has an instance of this a tunnel right here. Cool. I guess I always wanted to make sure these worked. Looks like this tunnel does work. Sweet. Oh, nice! Took me to here. Needed that. Map says there's an item in here. Huh. Map says there's something here, but that doesn't seem like there is. Secret wall. Inanimate objects be camouflaged as creatures? That's cool. There. There we go. Can we bomb through here? Oh, secret wall through right there. Spoiler alert! Spoiler alert! You have to battle for sanity with your own imagination? Poor Jib. Get to do anything with Dead Jib? I don't want to give away what it actually does. It's a secret to everybody. Simultaneous killer. It just means that you're killing more than one enemy at once. It's health bars? Health bars for what? One thing I haven't done is died. Let this time run out. I should let this time run out. Make sure this works. If you die here, you should restart back at... Actually, let's just get like farther away in the dungeon here. And say I'm like part way back. Almost there. I just die. Speed up time. Simultaneous. Yeah, it just means that you can kill more. You kill more than one enemy at once. Simultaneous. S-I-M-U-L-T. Okay, good. We start here. Man, it's gonna redo this though. Oh, you mean health bars for the bosses? Oh. Oh yeah, that's kind of a design aesthetic I'm trying to go with. I like the feeling that you don't know, right? Actually, what I wanted to do was, if, you know, the way I wanted to convey, I probably will eventually do this, is to make it so when the bosses are almost dead, they all have a different, different animations, so, or not different animations, but like a different skin or whatever, so they look like they're almost dead. Like the very first mini boss does that. When you get him down to half health, he starts looking all cracked and stuff like that. I'd like to do that with all these bosses. So the last few times I've saved the droid smith, I haven't changed any of that code either, so I guess I could just not save the droidsmith this time. I'll make sure that that works without saving him. And then he's like not here still. Yeah, cool. Glad you guys are backing me up on this one. Okay, so now what should initiate right here is I have the killabombs, so Zero should appear. Yeah, there he is. Cool. Nice. He guides me here. So there's a few little subtle things that help the player out in this last bit. People were really confused about that. Lots of people got stuck. Didn't know what to do after that part. Wait, what? This dialogue should not be happening. You left with the key. That was not even, I thought I took that out. Oh, Story Vel 1B? Oh, okay. Yeah, it played like a little bit, right? After, you're just saying that it's not playing now, is it? It was just played for a second or two after that teleport. I think it's okay if it plays for a second or two after the teleport. It's kind of like the feeling is that you were just inside all that chaos, and I kind of want to translate that feeling into that the next little scene there. So I think it's okay. Okay, I gotta save and quit and make sure that doesn't initiate twice. Or I mean, it doesn't initiate at all. If you basically, it's playing the Velt 1B audio, but it shouldn't play because you had Velt 1A. Okay, so has not Vel 1B, and this one is has not 1A. This one exists Jib, this one exists not Jib. So yeah, you shouldn't be able to have that audio play again. Cool, yeah, it was just a few seconds. I can always refine that later. If it feels like that needs to be silent immediately after that, I can do that. Okay, so we start here. Zero guides us. Why does he guide us that way? He goes around. Doesn't even need to. Okay, and so now when I go in here, it should not play this Vel 1B dialogue. Cool. Alright. Cool, so that dialogue felt pretty good. Just wrote that last night. I want to make sure it was still kind of feeling good. Oh, we have no idea where to go now, though. But at this point, you should know that the big door is pretty much... if you've done every other dungeon... Oh, I wonder what would happen... Oh, that's a good thing to try, actually. If we save and quit. I've never done this before. Why do random stepping stones appear for Velda Cross instead of those tall pillars falling down to form bridges? That could happen. I could do that too. I just did the little floating mooring tiles because I already had those. Christmas lights. The little bright highlights. What was I doing? Oh yeah. So if I just cheat and have all the bosses defeated, except for that one. So let's say I did complete the whole game, and I should still have it. Should still have a biodetector. So I've never tried this. I wonder if it actually guides you to that. Oh, looks like it might have worked. Cool. So yeah, there is a way for a player to find the last dungeon. Let's make sure that it did work though. Relatively close to home, actually. These stairs can sometimes be... The story element happened right when I paused. Bug? Lots of bugs. Stairs on the tower screen can look funny with nothing surrounding. This is cheese. The tall trees. Yeah, because it's nighttime. At nighttime, everything kind of lights up a little bit. The highlights look highlightier. This is 950. Because I paused, still has that red dot. Hopefully it was just because I paused, but not a big deal. Not too much of a big deal. A little bug. That's pretty much everything I wanted to test. But I'll complete the game anyways. Game for YouTube or Twitch. Not, it looks bad because of rain. Oh, you mean just because it's streaming? I guess it depends on the stream, their bitrate. Yeah. I guess it would totally depend on their bit rate that they're recording the video at, the resolution they're recording the video at, and those kind of things. Like, should be all right for most cases, as long as you've got your stream set up correctly. Yeah, this is the tower. This is the boss rush final dungeon. All the bosses are doubled up. Except for the lightning boss, which is hella hard. Oh, you guys don't freeze? Oh yeah, they do. Distracted. Fight her, not me. The lightning boss is really hard. I know it doesn't look hard, but hell, she's really hard. You found it? Yeah, I could always add an option for that. You found a video where it looks really bad? Oh, bitrate.
Alexa, turn on shades.
Advertisements. So focused. Which graphical bug? There's like a bajillion graphical bugs. You're talking about the reflections on the ground? Oh, I don't even have the glove. When I'm using invincibility. Oh shit, he landed on me. Yeah, so that's a debug mode thing only. Like, you it only happens in... Whoa, where am I? Take me back to the beginning, did it? Yeah. Because I was in invincible mode, the bombs actually are an entity, and that's why they can... You know, that's why they're an actual living entity, sort of, to the game. So, when you have invincibility on, they can't die, basically. No, the bosses weren't all... Once you get here to the top floor, or actually, once you beat the lightning boss, it saves something in your save file, so you don't have to fight all the bosses again. They don't ever appear again after you've done the lightning boss. And then you get up here, and you can save at this tower, at this refill thing, and warp back to it as well. So the game's kind of merciful in that way. You don't have to, like, fight all these bosses and the final boss all at once. I'm cheating. Once you start cheating, you can't stop. But yes, I just confirmed that the game is playable. Nothing is broken in this release. There's like not a single bug on my list that has to get done. That's great. Yay! Well, it was mostly controller stuff I worked on this week, and other little minor bugs, which were all confirmed. Cheaters never prosper. I know, I didn't prosper. I'll tell you that much. Last week, when I played in not cheat mode, it was great. I had a lot more fun. But this time, I didn't have as much fun playing the game because I cheated. Wah, wah. Oh, I hope it doesn't post my score to Steam. Oh, I'm not even connected to Steam, so it won't. Cool. All right. Well, there. It's confirmed that Songbringer is still a playable game. When I update this, I might even update this tonight. I can update it without any worries. A good tool for capturing GIFs. I don't know, on Windows. Alright, Ishni, see ya, man. Get some good rest. We'll see you later. Yep, so tonight I'll go and I'll have a little dinner break here, and I'll come back to this and prepare the release. I'll build it for all three platforms. You know, update the change log. Could you ignore scores that are too good? I could. Yeah. I've already got some code that ignores all my scores in debug mode. Yeah. I guess it would be kind of cool to ignore scores that are too good, but I don't know. I kind of want that to be a problem before I try and solve it. You know what I mean? Like, it's hard to solve a problem when you don't know the real requirements on it, because what if somebody actually does get a really, really, really good score? Kira Lore, shouldn't it just say by your name? Credit would be external help. What? What you mean? Weissman, where's my credit for helping with that eye modeling? Just write me, man. I'll put you in the credits. Yeah. No, seriously, I really mean that. Anybody that's watching the stream and you feel like you've contributed to this game and you're not on this list yet, you haven't... This is a list of people that have pre-ordered the game and backed the game, right? So everybody got their names on here. But if you feel like you deserve to be on this list, just write me. Write me an email. I'm nat@wizardfoo.com. I'll gladly put you on here. Thank you, all these people. There's still time to get your name on this list. Yeah, in the beginning you said you did the music, coding, etc. What do you mean though? Shouldn't it just say by your name, credit would be external help? I'm not sure what you mean by that. Credit would be external help? I don't understand that. Help me understand. Oh, I guess that's a good point, right? Yeah, Zilton and Mutinous. I guess I could clamp the scores. So that the most score you can get is 1 million. 1 million points would mean that you not only got every single item, you not only uncovered every single map area, but you also beat the game in 1 second. Which is literally impossible. No wait, you can get 1,100,000 points, because in permadeath mode it multiplies your score by 1.1. So yeah, your score is based on the time you completed it, the percent of map that you uncovered, and the percent of items you uncovered. So the time part is 1/3 of your score, and that's like, you know, less time you have, the higher your score is. So for you to get a top points for your score, for your time, you'd have to complete the game in 1 second. The first line should say "Buy Wizard Foo." Why is that? I prefer to use my own name for the credits, at least. Yeah, I know. You'd have to complete the game in 1 second. That would be quite the speed run. So basically, no one will probably ever to be able to legitimately get 1 million points. Or 1.1 million points, depending on if you're in permadeath mode. You've seen 1 second speedruns then? Really? Pokemon Red? Really? Oh yeah, I gotta make it so you can have two lines. Cause this line right here, Kyle Payne, the fantastic king of the universe, the blah 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 blah. There's like a whole other line in that guy's credit. Oh, there's a glitch that just sends you right to the end? That'd be quite the video, right? You gotta really pad that video with lots of other content. Yeah, well, we're getting ready. We're about to do this. You guys ready? Come on. And then you could have like an hour of commentary afterwards. You could talk about the code that actually causes the glitch. Ah, that's a good point. You could just stretch that out. It's not even 1 second? Latinus. A dark child. Matt L. Oh, so I think if you specifically say music, coding, etc., it cheapens your work. Either say it's by you or have music or and code on separate lines for people to actually appreciate the individual parts of the game. Oh, so you mean that basically that just putting all those credits on one line makes it seem like it's not... I don't know. I think I want to change it and make it so it just says something like, this game was made by one person, you can do the same kind of thing. You know? That's the whole point of it, is to make it like... a proven example that one person out there can make a game, do the programming, do the music, do the art, do the business, you know. Cure Lord, thanks for your feedback. I'll try and work on that. I'll make it better. I hate video games, yeah. I like the underscores one. Oh, Liver Mortis! You only need legs to kick ass. Yeah, right? Dead beef? All those fit into hexadecimal. Yeah, right? So one thing, I gotta make it so you can kind of speed through this if you really want to get to the end. Because there's gonna be a lot of names. And also, you can't exit the game or any. There's no way to exit the game during these credits. There's also no way to exit the game during any of the cutscenes or dialogue either. So does it do that? In other games, if you press, like, pause or whatever during an RPG's dialogue, can you get out of the game even if there's dialogue going on? I forget. I don't think I've ever tried to pause an RPG while there's dialogue. Does it have an end? Does it have an end? Yep, you can. You can pause during the dialogue. Most don't. So it's not weird. It's not weird that that Songbringer doesn't allow you to pause. That's good. Credits are just being pulled from online? Not in this game. They're all baked into they're baked into the data. There's a data file for all the backers. It's called credits.txt. Normally you see pausing give a continue or skip. Interesting. Oh, okay. So while the dialogue's going on, you press pause. And it gives you the option to skip the dialogue. Or skip, or continue. Pause brings us option to exit or go to the menu, but you have to leave. Yeah. The backer names are procedurally generated. I did that for my last game, for Hero Bash. I had to procedurally generate player names for doing multiplayer with with bots. Like, there's all these bots and whatever, and they had all their names. But I can tell you from doing that, that these names are so much more real. When you try and procedurally generate names, it's like, or at least the algorithm I had just really sucked. Because I just, like, used a bunch of, like, regular names and patterns that were just very... You could tell. You could just tell that it wasn't, they weren't real names. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, nice, man. So that white square is going to be your player. You've done a pretty good job so far, man. I like it. I like your art. Wiser man, right? Well, there you go. That's going to be it for today's stream. Dinner time for me. So, thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for all your support. I appreciate you. And we'll see you all next time. Cool. Yeah. Have a good night, everybody.